that's weeping somewhere. A pain has no wife, and the wind that cries Mary.
Face is getting a little better.
If you're an independent business, get HoneyBook. And many of your proposals.
I would pay. You see, the thing is, I would buy the YouTube Premium just to get rid of those annoying fucking ads. But you know what sucks? Is so many people have built in ads into their programming that you can't get around it still. There's this thing as ad free. It's like, I don't want your shit. You know, I will watch your program. You know, but there's always some special company, I guess, that can't get advertising, you know, in other ways. They just sponsor a YouTube show. Now, I don't think I want a sponsor. You know, I don't do this for money. I don't know, maybe I do it for fame. I don't know. Being famous doesn't seem real fun, though. I mean, it's cool in a way, but yeah, I'm sure it gets tiring really fast. Yeah, my face is starting to come back down. See, there's a lymph node right around in here. Part of my lymph node. And like this one down here. So like, see, on this side of face, it's not so bad. But on this side, it got really bad. See how this one goes? This one won't go as far. Yeah, it's still swollen. I can feel the mass. It'll go away eventually. It's called lymphadenopathy. I was diagnosed with that about five or six years ago. It's very painful. Well, nobody called me on the idea or had any comment about it or whatever. I think it's a good idea. Y'all have these programs where people can, you know, apparently, hold on. That's better. We have these programs where people can take in autistic people, you know, or development disabled people. I don't know. It's like you can. And the government, I think, will actually pay people to take in these people. And basically, I guess it becomes like a family mascot, you know, or a human pet. Well, what I don't understand is why don't we have that for everyone? or for maybe some people, you know, we have so many homeless people in this world, you know, and I mean, COTS is apparently booked out for the summer. And they don't mention it's funny in the article, they don't mention any other nonprofits like ANU because nobody wants to put their name in an article because they know I'm going to comment about it. And now they're going to get an email from me saying, oh, you know, you should know that this organization, blah, 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 you know, yada, 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 yada. And they don't want to hear it because they don't care. They just want to write an article. I don't understand why we don't have programs like that where we can't find people who have homes who are receptive to people, you know, maybe renting a room out from them. You know, maybe that's an idea that could work. The only problem is that the only people who usually want to partake in something like that, on here and there, there'll be decent people who really want to do something good or right. It's usually one with a bunch of communal narcissists. Oh, I'm the only one that cares. You know, and then they think that part of that caring for someone is them taking over their fucking life and then basically dictating everything that they do, which is a really inhumane thing to do, like, you know, like ANU does. But I don't understand why it is we can't start a program with people who either have, let's say, how about this? How about we have a program where people who are homeless but are non-threatening, you know, like, there are a lot, people want to say, just because people are homeless doesn't mean they're dangerous. And it's kind of like, well, that's true. But you can't always completely one-side everything. You can't be like, all homeless people are good people. No, some homeless people are scary as shit. Trust me. Look at me. Look how fucking scary I am. I mean, how I'm scary is only how you falsely perceive me because you don't know how to relate to an autistic person. Frankly, I don't think anyone here in Vermont really knows how to relate to anyone who's not from Vermont. You have your own little unique little hillbilly, you know, hippie culture here. That's unlike any hillbilly hippie culture I've ever seen. See, I'm not a danger. I mean, I might be a danger to someone who's a crook. I might be a danger to someone who is committing fraud. Yeah, you really want Rain Man, you know, coming by and fucking auditing your shit without you even realize that's what he's doing? Because here's the thing. No matter where I go, there's nothing I don't notice. If I see a slightest little inkling of a pattern or something that ain't right, my brain's just going to... Warning, warning! That's my self-defense mechanism. When I see some things that are especially egregious, that's another thing. People like use that word around here about egregious behavior. Your behavior I experienced from ANU was extremely egregious. Now, that actually was egregious. But people who, you know, who are not actually egregious but homeless, maybe we should have a program where, you know, there could be some sort of incentive for people to help those people out, and, you know, if they got an extra room, if they've got a mother-in-law suite. And I think that HUD can help flip the bill for that. As long as their home, you know, meets, you know, basic, you know, habitational requirements. What the fuck is that? Every car looks the fucking same now. What's the deal with that? Everything looks like a spaceship on wheels. I think that's a great idea. I truly do. And I think that, you know, we could get sponsorship, you know, from some of our senators. Like, I would feel like, you know, Senator Peter Welch and Bernie Sanders would love that idea. Now, I don't know if it's necessarily politically in their advantage to, you know, support something like that. We got millions of homeless people in this world. And I know there's millions of people that have extra bedrooms. There's millions of people that got attics that might be easily converted into a small one-bedroom, a small studio apartment, you know, or a basement, you know, that, you know, a mother-in-law suite in a basement somewhere. And the only reason why they're not doing anything about using it is because it's too much of a hassle or because they can't find a way to get funding from HUD to help pay them some rent Or maybe these particular things need to be kind of like in a way, I hate to put it this way because it puts in a connotation that homeless people are like children. But what about a foster home for the homeless until we could find them permanent housing? Can't we have a HUD program where we could have people who are pre-approved? Here's the thing. The problem with Vermont is that y'all want to take every single bit of effort you can to process something to the point where it becomes obvious that people just want to get rich off of helping. Look at Howard Center. That's one of the problems I have with them, is that everything is a billing opportunity. It's not about helping people, it's a billing opportunity. Eyes are sinking back in my head now. My morning meds haven't kicked in yet, and I'm already starting to feel like a headache, so I got to take my glasses off. Those have helped me from getting a headache from too much sunlight exposure. But the pressure on the side of my head from the glasses, from the, you know, these things pushing it to the side of my head will restrict, you know, blood flow enough that it'll fuck up my damn lymph nodes. Why don't we have something like that? I'm not saying this is easy. And I'm not saying it's not going to need some tweaking or some twerking or something, you know, but I think it can be done. And I think that it's a way that we can show people how to, you know, how everyone can take part in helping out our world, because I'm getting tired as communal narcissists. Only we have the answer. You know, that's Virginia Finn and the New and Kevin Bacon and, oh, who the fuck else that new guy is over there? Only we care. How about we all care? Can we do that? You know, that lady over at the right, she said she's got one of them autistic kids chained up in her yard. Can't we do that for the homeless too? One thing you have to understand is most people who are homeless are either vulnerable people who have not been recognized as being truly vulnerable, like myself. You know, I went years without people realizing, well, I am vulnerable. You might think, well, he's smart enough now how to fuck these people back makes him not vulnerable. But it's the fact of the matter, because I am vulnerable, is the reason why I have to go through such extreme measures to protect myself or to get things fucking evened out. What do y'all think of that idea? Of course, y'all don't like it because it's not your idea. That's the whole thing. And some people I'm not speaking will assume that I'm saying that you don't care. When I know some people do care, but there's some people out there I know don't care, but yet project to the public that they do care when they actually don't. Why? Because they don't take anyone else's idea, no matter how good it is, and use it. Not unless they can wrongly claim credit for their idea as their own. But you see, when someone like me comes along and I start publishing things online, then they don't want to take my idea because they can't outright steal it from me and claim it as their own. But they don't want to implement it. But I have a feeling people like Bernie Sanders and Peter Welch, I would say that nice lady that we elect to Congress, but yeah, to pay for her office, they won't, you know. Oh, well. I mean, I could always call D.C. sweetheart. You being a bitch to me over the phone. You know, at the local office, yeah, I'm not stupid. I know how to work this process a lot better than you do. Becca Ballant. I would think they'd want to sponsor something like that. We will get people. Here's the thing. You got to understand something. Remember when, you know, Russia, you know, or, you know, the United Soviet Socialist, was it United or the Union? I thought it was the Union of Soviet Socialist. That's why they call it the Soviet Union. But then someone else said it's United Soviet Socialist Republic, or the CCCP. I think CCCP is just Russian for USSR. And, but I don't understand why it is. They put together the shittiest apartment buildings. It took them, they put them together in weeks. Those big ass apartment complexes, they built those buildings in weeks. But it still took them years just to get around to doing it. And then it took them forever to organize the shit to get them in. So we need some sort of bridge. We got to get over this shit. You know how we're going to get over it? By building a bridge. So let's make a bridge. Let's have an intermediary thing where... And the thing is, you can't make it where these people... Because here's a problem. There's so many people that would love... You have this program where autistic people just go live with somebody, some family. Just because they're a family don't mean they're not dangerous. Doesn't mean they're not abusive. Doesn't mean they're not narcissistic people or just being predatory and looking for an opportunity. It's just like, you know, I keep seeing these things, you know, in the last... Well, I've heard these conversations about this too, is that, you know, like women who will only date people who are not U.S. citizens are predators. They have a tendency to always be dating a guy with a green card. Yeah, because they want the upper hand in the relationship. They want to control somebody. Well, I don't want that to happen to people as a matter of that too. But I think that is a good idea. I think maybe if we had our government help sponsor that, it helped work out a way where we could compensate people, say, for 6 months. Let's do it for like 6 months to see if they can somewhat behave good enough, you know, that they could actually either live with another family or they could, you know, live in a trailer on their lot or in a camper on their lot. Or maybe we can put a one of them bubble sheds. Maybe we can start letting people have a pod at their house in their backyard. You know, that way they're not all congregated somewhere in the middle of town, but yet they're dotted around. What do y'all think about that idea? Hey, y'all want to steal my ideas? Go for it. I have shit tons of them. You will claim it as your own, okay. But when you steal my idea, do it right. All right? You know, so when you run into a hiccup in your idea, how about you contact me and ask me how to better steal the idea to make sure it goes right? It's not about me. I mean, if I wanted to make it about me, I could, but you know what? I have such zero respect for communal narcissists that I would fucking hate myself. I'd be so pissed off at myself. I don't think I would ever let myself or me be okay with that. You know, I think that what we need to do is we need to actually solve the problem. The problem is that corporations like Cathedral Square, organizations like, they depend on people being homeless. And they depend on using that as a fear tactic to make sure people go along with their shit. It's called learned helplessness. They have the upper hand in every way because we've given it to them. Well, I say that, you know, we start evening things out. And we start letting more people who want to help, help. Without making it so that it becomes no good deed goes unpunished. Maybe we should have it where a good deed gets rewarded. But you actually have to do a good deed. You can't do it for your benefit. Just for your benefit. Just so you can use it as a means to make people think that you're someone that you're not. Okay? I think it's a great idea. We'll see. Love, can't you see? On my mother, almost. Started a jam. And you're going back. I'm gonna turn me around. Always yours. Damn, I forgot what it was. Lord, can't you see what that woman long's been doing to me? Can't you see? Learning how to sing better. What that woman long's been doing. Get out my boomer rock guitar. Yeah, this era of, you know, shit where people market, you know, helping people as we're loving and holistic. Yeah, that shit needs to end. So, yeah, I wish I could start my own organization where I actually would help people and I'd go, yeah, we don't love you. We may like you. We may grow to like you. Who knows? Over years, we may grow to love you. But we will not love you when you come in the door. We will be concerned about your well-being, though. We'll be concerned to make sure that you're a human being and gets treated like a human being. You know, we may not like you, but we will do what's right, even if we don't like you. See, that really bothers me when organizations like I do that. Loving holistic care. Yeah, bullshit. Yeah, I think that I could prove that on Etch-a-Sketch that they're not loving and caring. If they're continue to have someone like Virginia Finn working there, working her transition housing program, suckering people into her goddamn program so that she can basically prop herself up so she can get away with doing whatever she wants to do that's wrong because everybody misperceives her as caring when she's not. She's predatory. That's what I want to end. And I wish it, you know, if I wasn't someone who was completely denied the ability to be able to do something in this world and use my abilities and talents to help others and create a better environment. And I don't mean environment like talking about, carbon footprints or whatever. I'm talking about environment like, you know, emotionally our environment, mentally our environment. I see a lot of people, you know, decide that they just want to go all in on 100% on a narrative, not realizing that you're actually going to cause a lot of harm to all the people who aren't involved in your narrative by pushing the narrative the way that you are. We need to have an anti-narrative, a homeless campaign. Can we do that? Because the thing is, people, you don't have to sit there and guilt trip people to get them to help. People who want to help will just help. If you have to guilt trip someone into helping, that's someone who doesn't want to help, and they're just going to wind up taking advantage of the situation. A flood of homeless people in this world. And I say we put down some towels and some sandbags and shit. And I say we sop up all these extra homeless people and we'll make them part of some families out there. Maybe that's what they need. Maybe they need a family. Maybe it could be like, you know, a bum idol, you know, like American Bum Idol or something, you know, they could all compete to get a family or something. I don't know. I mean, you gotta find some way to fuck over people, you know, and exploit them for your entertainment in order to help them, right? Or something like that. I don't know. We'll see. But my lymphadenopathy is starting to get a little better. It'll probably get worse again next week because I'm gonna have a really stressful week next week, I'm sure. But that's my Sunday morning. Or what is it? It's Saturday, damn it. Saturday morning message. Say hi to your mama and them for me. Love y'all. Bye.